This is a vintage original American three-sheet poster for the film Meet Me in St. Louis, starring Judy Garland. From 1944, this poster was heavily creased, ripped, and damaged, so we gave it a poster fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix Studio. We're coming to you from Building 77 at the Brooklyn Navy Yard, and this is a three-sheet poster for Meet Me in St. Louis. We've removed the tape that was on the back to make sure that it's clean so that we can linen back it. Linen backing is a process where we take your vintage poster and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. I'm lifting that acid-free paper up right now. Or I should say Hercules has lifted it. It's important that we get rid of those air pockets that are between the acid-free paper and the cotton canvas, and that's why he's rolling it out. And now the screen is ready for linen backing. Meet Me in St. Louis is a 1944 American Christmas musical film made by Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer. Divided into a series of seasonal vignettes, starting with summer of 1903. It relates the story of a year in the life of the Smith family in St. Louis, leading up to the opening of the Louisiana Purchase Exposition, more commonly referred to as the World's Fair, in the spring of 1904. The film stars Judy Garland, Margaret O'Brien, Mary Astor, Lucille Bremer, Tom Drake, Leon Ames, Marjorie Main, June Lockhart, and Joan Carroll. The film was adapted by Irving Brecker and Fred Finkelhoff from a series of short stories by Sally Benson, originally published in the New Yorker magazine called The Kensington Stories.
As this paper absorbs the wheat paste, the paper expands.
The film was directed by Vincent Minnelli, who met Garland on the set and later married her. Tony Award-winning designer Lemuel Ayres served as the film's art director.
The reason why they call these three-sheet posters is because they're the size of three one-sheet posters.
The paper has expanded, and now I have to stretch it out with my hand. It's good and wet, so I'm going to use a roller to start pushing out the air and the excess wheat paste. This paper absorbs the wheat paste very well. Quickly, in fact. Absorbs the water. It expands quickly. Old paper like this is actually more of a pleasure to work with than is paper print, paper produced after the 1980s. And specifically in the last 20 years, I can't bring back many of the posters that come my way.
Upon its release, Meet Me in St. Louis was both a critical and a commercial success. It became the second highest grossing film of 1944, behind only Going My Way, and was also MGM's most successful musical of the 1940s. In 1994, the film was deemed culturally, historically, or aesthetically significant by the Library of Congress and selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry.
And now I'm wiping off all the excess wheat paste from around the edge and then from the face of the poster to make sure it's nice and clean before I put down the next sheet.
Judy Garland debuted the standard songs The Trolley Song, The Boy Next Door, and Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, all of which became hits after the film was released. The film's producer, Arthur Freed, also wrote and performed one of the songs.
Okay, we've got this first sheet linen back. We've got the space to put the rest of it down now. This one will be more difficult to move because there is a big rip in it, and I may end up separating the sheet to help prevent further damage. I may just separate it because there's only 3 inches attached here and a short piece attached there. I don't know what to do. Let me think about it. Don't go away. We'll be right back. To rip or not to rip. We're back in the poster fix shop and I'm ready to put this remaining piece of the poster down onto the linen backing. This is Meet Me in St. Louis, starring Judy Garland.
I'm going to do something bold. I'm not going to actually rip the poster anymore because it's attached so well and it'll make it harder for me if I put it down in sections. So I'm just going to put wheat paste over the whole area that needs it and gently put it down. I have a way of doing it. You'll see. Keep watching.
The backdrop for the film is St. Louis, Missouri, in the year preceding the 1904 Louisiana Purchase Exposition World's Fair. In the summer of 1903, the Smith family leads a comfortable, upper-middle-class life. Alonzo Smith and his wife, Anna, have 4 daughters, Rose, Esther, Agnes, and Tootie, and a son, Juan Jr. Esther, the second oldest daughter, is in love with the boy next door, John Truitt, although he does not notice her at first. Tootie rides with Iceman Mr. Neely and debates whether St. Louis is the nation's top city. Rose, the eldest daughter, hopes in vain to receive a marriage proposal from Warren Sheffield. Judy Garland was unhappy with the script and unsure of herself as a leading lady at the time. She also suffered from severe emotional problems and some addictions to amphetamines and numerous physical ailments such as recurring migraine headaches. Judy also balked at Minnelli's heavy schedule of rehearsals and pre-recording sessions in the months preceding filming, but Minnelli won her confidence and the two became lovers, cohabitating by the time of the film's post-production and marrying soon after its release. Earlier in the production, Judy Garland had a brief affair with her co-star, Tom Drake. Vincent Minnelli's idea to introduce each season segment with a greeting card illustration dissolving into live action was most likely influenced by a similar technique used in Orson Welles' 1942 film, The Magnificent Ambersons. Freed's process for Meet Me in St. Louis established a pattern for Minnelli's future musicals. Budgets in excess of $1 million, pre-production schedules sometimes exceeding a full year, shooting schedules of 3 to 6 months, and post-production phases of 6 months or longer. There is one song that Judy Garland sang in this film called Boys and Girls Like You and Me. Well, the song survives, but the film footage has been lost. It was cut out of the film. This song was originally composed by Rodgers and Hammerstein for their Broadway musical Oklahoma, but were cut prior to its opening. So I guess that song was never in any show. Upon its 1944 release, Meet Me in St. Louis, one was a gigantic critical and commercial success. During its initial theatrical release, it earned a then massive $5,016,000 in the US and Canada and $1,550,000 elsewhere, resulting in a profit of $2,359,000.
Okay, so the entire poster has now been linen backed. I have to go over it with a sponge or two and wash off that wheat paste from the face of it. There's an old stain here and an old puncture that looks like it's been repaired in the past. Thank you.
And now I'm going over the entire poster with a sponge and cleaning off all the excess wheat paste which is on the face of the poster. I want to make sure that it's good and clean so that there are no streaks on it after it dries. And once I've got it all nice and clean, we are finished.
We're going to let this poster dry on the screen for a couple of days before we commence with the paper fill restoration and the touch-up. And you won't want to miss that. So don't go away. We'll be right back with Judy.
We are back in the poster fix shop, and my wife Oki is going into this poster with water reversible gouache to in-paint the areas where the color is missing. We're also using a blow dryer to accelerate the drying and to help to affect the level of gloss that's in the dried paint. Something that's interesting about the printing of this poster, it is printed in lithography, not in offset printing. It's unusual because by 1944, most American posters were being printed by offset using a mechanical color separation rosette pattern as opposed to the random dots of a lithograph, where the artwork is done directly on the plates. So this poster resembles the old French posters of the turn of the century. Even the rendering of the dress resembles it. And the color is very rich, just as one would expect in lithography. By the way, Meet Me in St. Louis is based on Sally Benson's 5135 Kensington stories, although the film took some liberties by having the family remain in St. Louis at the end of the movie instead of moving to New York. Meet Me in St. Louis had its world premiere in St. Louis, Missouri on the 22nd of November 1944, and its New York opening on the 28th of November 1944. We are celebrating the centennial of Judy Garland's birth this year, and it's been our honor and privilege to Lindenback and restore this three-sheet poster for Meet Me in St. Louis, starring the great Judy Garland. Thank you.